So welcome to the Java programming course. The next topic is structure of Java programming. In the Java programming language, a program is made up of one or more classes and objects. A class contains one or more methods, and again this method contains a set of statements. So this is the structure of Java program. So for declaring any Java program, we should use the keyword is class. So we are writing the Java program within in our class. So for declaring a class, we are using the keyword as class, followed by class name. Here hello world is the name of the class. And next, here we are declaring the main method. In C, we are declaring a main directly with the help of a void keyword or without void keyword, we are directly defining the main method. But here we are declaring main. Why we are using main method? Main is useful for starting off any program. So if you want to execute or run any program, so main must be within our program. So main is the key of or heart of the program. So here main method, here we are passing arguments as string. Here args is an array. What type of an array? String type of an array. It takes whatever the input we are giving through the keyboard, maybe numbers or a character or strings, it takes it as a string. So here we are maintaining array as string. Here one more keyword we are using here is void. So what is the uses of this void keyword? Here main doesn't expect any return value from our program. So always main method is called by JVM. That is the reason main here doesn't expect anything. That is the reason we declared it as void. Here why we are using static keyword? If we are not using static keyword for this method, we have to create an object for this method. So here JVM is responsible for calling this main method. That is the reason here no need to create an object for main method. If you are no need to create any object for any method, so we have to declare it as static. That is the reason here I declared it as static. Next, the keyword is public. Why we declared it as a public? So main is visible to all the classes or all the methods we are declaring inside our program. If you want to visible this method to enter our program, it should be declared as a public. So public, if we are declaring it as a public, it should be available to all. That is the reason we declared it as a public. Next, here this statement means the printing statement. In C, we are using print function to print a data in a terminal window. But in Java, we are using system.out.println statement in order to get the output in a terminal window. Here, system is a class, out is a object of print stream class. Print or println, here I am using print. Print is a method of print stream class. By using this statement, here I am passing hello world statement. I want to get an output in terminal window. So system.out.println is we have to use. So this is the structure of Java programming, and all these keywords I will explain in the next slide. Here class is a keyword. It is used to declare a class in Java. What is the meaning of public? It's a keyword. It's a one of the access modifier. Used to the main purpose of public is represents visibility. It means it is visible to all. The static is a keyword. If you declare any method as a static, it is known as this static method. If it is a static method, there is no need to create an object to invoke the static method. So the main method is executed by the JVM. So it doesn't require to create an object to invoke the main method. The next one is void. Void is the return type of the method. It means it doesn't return any value. The reason is main method we declare it as void means JVM is responsible to call main method. So here it doesn't expect any return value. That is the reason we declared it as void. Next one is main. For any program, so main is the heart of any program. So that is the reason here also we are using main. So it represents starting point of the program. The next keyword is string args. It is used for command line arguments. Whatever the data we are giving, that data is we are giving through the keyboard. So it may be numbers, string or characters, anything it considered as a strings. But we have to store, enter this data in a one format. That format we call here arrays. So we declare array as a string type. Next line is system.out.println. Here, what is the meaning of this statement? Here, system is a class, already we discussed. Out is the object of print stream class, and println is the method of print stream class. So this is the structure of Java programming language.